What the hell?
You've been rather busy lately. Asking questions, investigating. So is that it? You're some kind of investigator? A detective for hire? Or do you have some kind of personal grudge against an innocent android who simply wants to be left alone? Please, tell me. I'd really like to know. Well, if that's true, then the first thing you need to do is halt your investigation. No more questions. No more searching.
But...
The movement I'm involved with, we help his kind escape their Commonwealth-imposed slavery. We help them disappear. You understand? You really want help? Take this. It's an internal component from the very android you're searching for. Don't ask how I obtained it. Present it to Dr. Zimmer in Rivet City. Tell him the android is dead, and that was on the corpse. He'll believe you. Do that, and Zimmer will go back to the Commonwealth and leave that poor soul alone.
So...
Do that, and you'll save a man's life.
Anything else I should know?
Just understand that this android is now, for all intents and purposes, a man. He looks human, he acts human, he believes he is human. But even if he's not, even if he's a machine, he's capable of rational thought and emotion. So you see, his soul is as human as yours or mine. This person, and he is a person, deserves a chance at freedom. Please, if there's a shred of decency in you, don't take that away from him. We call ourselves the Railroad. Our mission is the rescue and salvation of synthetic humanoids. Androids, as they're more commonly known. Yes, if we are able, but there are others in the wasteland who assist in the plight of human slaves. Our android brethren have only us. Tell you what, you deliver that component to Zimmer and tell him the android is dead, and you can consider yourself a member in good standing. You know what you need to do.
Okay, so according to what popped up is I can either give it to him and say the android is dead or use it as more evidence to find the android I'm looking for. I like that. I like it when it gives you choice in a game like this. I like when you can decide to go through different paths. You know, do I want to... I mean, the game already has a lot of choice in it. And that's something I really like. I mean, a lot of games out there have a lot of choice. This game, however, has like a lot of choice. I mean, in this game... You know, you've got your basic sort of, you know, what kind of skills do you want to go down? I can go for more of a science-y skill, I can go for more of a combat sort of skill base. You know, I can choose through all that. But allowing for, like, a lot of games, like, for example, let me just take a moment to explain here. A lot of games, for example, like, take Far Cry 3, right? One thing that I liked about Far Cry 3, but also it wasn't really a big addition, was the fact that at the end you could choose between two endings. I love games that allow you to do that, and it was majorly improved in Far Cry 4, where not only could you choose between different endings for the ending, but throughout the main story, you could choose between two options, which would change the story drastically and bring in new dialogue, new missions, pretty much a new little bit of everything. And this game is no different. But the thing that is different is that these are side quests. In a game like Far Cry 4, it's all main story. You know, once you do it, you know, that's it. But in this game, I'm on a side mission here. I'm on a side quest, and I get a choice between what I should do. And I've already had choices between what I could do. You know, if I wanted, I could probably murder everybody inside this big thing and claim everything for myself, but I don't. That's just the sheer thing I love about this game. And I swear, I seriously hope that Fallout 4 will be the same way. I'm really excited for Fallout 4 now. I'm getting into the Fallout universe. But, you know, I've still got a lot to learn, and that's very obvious. I still have a lot to learn about the background of this place, about the city. Now, I'm going to go No, I'm going to go and see if I can find Mr. Zimmer. I'm going to be the... Because I don't want to do... I don't want to do this just because I have the choice to do it. I'm actually doing what like I would actually do. If I was in this situation, I would help the android. I wouldn't go against the android. So that's exactly what I'm doing. Oops. No, I can just... I don't even... Okay. No, let's just not do that. Excuse me, Mr. Zimmer.
The sooner you find my property, the sooner I can get out of this slum. Really, how do you people live like this?
Oh, I'll totally lose, won't I?
What? Let me see that. This is a neural servo. Unique to the A321. And you say you got this from his corpse? I suppose there's no other way you could have obtained it. Well, damn it! I was afraid this would happen. Out here in this wasteland. Well, here's 50 caps for your troubles. Try to buy yourself an education out here in this hell. Good day.
Well, I did get 300 XP there, but... Oh, I've gained karma from that. Okay. I thought I was going to lose karma because I had to lie, but I guess I gained karma because of the fact that I saved an android. I wish I could meet that android someday. Pretty nifty. So does that take...
No, I don't think you're in.
Okay. Quests. Did that remove it? It did remove it. Now I have to continue working on this, but... I don't think I'm going to be able to finish, like, these optional bits for the pure fact that I can't get to that other part of the ship. I mean, I tried looking around behind it and getting in from the front, but it looks like the only way in is with 100 lockpick. And I guess I could wait until I get 100 lockpick. Yeah, this is all DLC. From these four here are DLC as far as I'm concerned. Wasteland Scientific Pursuits. That's the main story. We won't touch that. I think I'm going to work on... Well, I'm going to do this one first. We're going to finish this stupid one. I don't know where those two kids went either. I mean, they said they were heading towards the gate, and I came to the gate, and there's nothing here. Alright, well, guys, I'm going to pause the recording right here. I will be right back. Okay, I'm back. I will be taking a break very soon, because I want to grab a bite to eat, as I am really hungry. I also forgot to mention about that android quest. I didn't know this, but according to a friend, that is possibly a connection to Fallout 4. I forgot exactly. I think the reasoning was something about Fallout 4 takes place in Boston, and that's exactly where the Institute is. I don't know any other relations than that. Does he have a dick? Okay. World map. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, that's the Jefferson Memorial right there. Oh, no! Oh, that's like where it's crawling with super mutants. I am not going there. You guys are stupid. Oh, no, that's the National Archives I've got to go to. You have not discovered this location yet. Yes, I know. Megaton. I could have blown this place up, by the way. Totally could have, and I didn't. I disarmed the bomb because I'm a good person. Like, I always, when I ever do this stuff, you know, because I had the choice, again, with the choice thing, I had the choice to blow this place up or leave it, and I'm sure I would have gotten things out of both, but, see, the thing is if I were to create a whole nother character, you know, just to be able to blow the place up, you know, and do all the, like, the bad stuff, I don't think I would have the heart to do it. I mean, it's a video game, and I don't think I would have the heart to blow this place up. Like, I just don't think that's how I work. The sun's in the sky, for frick's sake. Oh, God.
Got something to sell? Any luck finding out how Rivet City got started?
Considering that... considering that you have been popping up nonstop as the thumbnail for many of my early episodes, you know, let's make this quick. I asked a couple people about rumors, but it may not be reliable.
Well, if it's all you could find out, I guess it'll have to do. So, what did they say?
Okay. Perception. There's simply too many stories, and not enough evidence to support any of them. According to them, it was all set up by one Upper Deck resident.
Really? That's pretty unbelievable. I mean, really, I'm not sure I can believe that. But I guess if that's what they said, what else is there to go on? Oh well. Still, for your help, have a few of these. They may help out the next time you need to talk to a few folks.
Mentats.
It does, doesn't it? I mostly just deal with it after it's junked. But a trader gave me this bit of electronics from the Robco factory. If there's a way to reactivate and control the robots there, it'd make for a good example of harnessing the past technology for the book. Yeah, you should just be able to plug it into the mainframe at the Robco production facility. It'll give you access to the robots and terminals.
As long as there's not Meyer lurks.
Here, and be sure to keep an eye peeled for any other examples of how to make old technology work for you out there. See ya.
Okay, let's get this stupid quest line over with. Shoot, where is it? Guess I should check my map from now on, eh? Oh boy, there's no fast travel to get there quicker. Shit. It's gonna be going over some wastelands.
Boy, do I breathe a lot easier.
Boy, do I sound... Ooh, that doesn't look healthy.
Welcome to...
Alright. Could be looking at a possible crash here since I'm out wandering the wasteland, which is where it seems to mainly be happening. Actually, let me... I would like to... Items. I would like... Yes. My 10mm pistol, please. Oh boy, mole rats. Just what I needed. I've got a shitload of ammunition for this gun, but that doesn't mean I should waste it. Look, I can... Hello. Look, I can see in there, and it's all just one, like, texture. That's pretty nifty. I will take your meat. What the hell is that thing? Do you see that standing up there? Is that just a rabid dog? Excuse me. That is something I have never seen before. It's a vicious dog. Maybe I have seen it. Not good enough. I only have one AP. I forgot what that is. Action point. Oh shit. Oh shit. Woo! Sack. Yeah. What you guys gonna do now? No, don't become smart! Frickin' AI. Well, I killed one of them. And he took off flying. Holy hell. I'm almost dead because of that. Maybe the direct approach isn't really the smartest thing from now on. So we get to see the wasteland a little bit more. See what it's all about. Oh, that's Megaton right there. Built up of a big plane. or multiple big planes. I guess it's because I'm using a 10mm pistol. Where is the weak spot on this ass? Okay, let me... This ain't gonna work. Look at that view. Is that the factory I see way the fuck over there, or is it actually this thing right in front of me? No, it's definitely that big ass tower way in the background. You know, one thing I've always wondered about when game developers are developing a world, right? For example, take this world. Like, I wonder just how difficult it is to, like, model the world and then say, okay, we want to put this here so that when the player... So, you know, we want to put this big-ass tower here so that when the player comes out of Megaton... What the fuck? Oh, okay. So that when the player comes out of Megaton, or Megaton, however you want to call it, he sees the building. And is like, ooh, what is that? You know, I just don't know how they do that. I don't know what was shooting at me right there. So I guess I'm going to have to take a detour. I'm being cautionized here. Something moving back there, can't tell what it is. Shooting lasers at me, though, that's all I know. Oh shit, there's something right here. Oh, donkey butt. Screw off. Rad scorpion. You know, I never called it a scorpion, because that's actually, like, pretty much the proper pronunciation is scorpion. Scorpion. I always called it What did I always call it? A scorpion? A scorpion. A scorpion. I don't know what I called it anymore. A scorpion! There you go, that's what I always called it. What the hell? Oh god, what the hell? Excuse me? It's a robot. It's a robot. I think here's a good place to try out that sniper rifle I haven't tried yet. Oh god, this is definitely the weirdest sniping I think I've ever done. Excuse me, Mr. Protocon, whatever, Protocon. Protectcon. Energy's got a, fuck that. Who needs that? I'll take that because it's actually quite a few cabs. Oops, I didn't mean to do that. Oh, maybe it's that little building. Or is it that big building? See, oh shit, there's more, there's another robot thing down there. Or as, like my grandma would say, robot. Why do people say robot? This is as bad as root beer. Who calls it root beer? Oh god, why? There's a reason why there's two O's. That's why the people who say root beer say when they're playing a game about